CultureBuzz, Shalom. My name is Ruth Direktor. I was born in Tel Aviv. I live in Tel Aviv, but I work as the chief curator of Haifa Museum of Art, and this is where we are now, Haifa Museum of Art. And we are now in the exhibition called Art's Outer Circles, Outsiders, Naive, and Autodidact, which means we are talking about a very, very interesting phenomenon of outsider artists who never learned art, were never part of the art circles, but still they created art that is considered today wonderful, special, very, very unique. And what we show here is actually the first outsider art exhibition in Israel ever. Never before, outsider artists which are considered today classical outsider artists, although it sounds as a contradict of terms, never before have been shown in Israel. So let us walk around and we'll see some of the classical outsiders from abroad, as well as naive and self-taught and folk artists from Israel. Are you ready? This is the first floor where we show two artists whom we can't show their pieces in the museum, but these are people who live in certain places and created their works in their home. This, what we see here, is a documentation of a woman artist who immigrated from Yemen. She lived in Shlomi, which is a development city in the north, and she covered the walls of her house completely, totally, with these wonderful colors. And on the other side, we see an artist who lives in Sydney Alley, which is near Herzliya. He lives there for 40 years, and he's building his place, his home, on the beach. And this is also a documentation, since we couldn't bring anything to the museum. So this is the entrance to the exhibition. Masterpieces of this unique art, artists who were in hospital, who were in mental hospitals in the first part of the 20th century, Alois, Carlo Zinelli. They were hospitalized and they were doing works while they were in the hospital. And as you can see, all the works were painted from both sides of the paper. You see, because they didn't have materials, they didn't have enough paper, so they painted on both sides. And as you can see, Alois, she also was sewing with threads the papers one to another. You see, these are threads of the papers. And what you see here, like, for example, this piece of Carlo Zinelli, which is beautiful, wonderful. You see what we call horror vacui, which is the anxiety from open space. So the paper is totally full with letters, with syllables, with words, and with images. One of the masters of the outsider art is called Henry Darger. He's from Chicago. And in some of the cases of the outsider artists, there is a story of discovery, a very special moment of discovery. This man was working as a janitor for all his life in Chicago. And only before he died, when he was old, his landlord entered the one-bedroom flat that he rented for him for more than 40 years, and he found two huge boxes full with thousands and thousands of drawings and texts. And the good luck is that this landlord was a photographer himself. He was an artist. His name was Nathan Lerner, Jewish-American photographer, quite known. And he realized that this is a treasure, because otherwise another landlord could have just thrown into the garbage and we would never have known about a man called Henry Darger. So this is why when I write the text in the exhibition, as you can see, I try to emphasize this moment of discovery, because there is always an insider who sees these kind of words and realize they're important. So Henry Darger actually invented an epos of four girls. They were called the Vivian girls, and they were running away all the time from terrible and cruel guys. His paintings are, on the one hand, very beautiful, as if pastoral looking, but when you look carefully, they are very shocking and disturbing. From Safed, the Zegelmacher from Safed. He was a watchman. He was making toys out of wood, and as I was telling you, there is always an insider. So the insider who saw his toys was Yossel Bergner, who was a painter, and he told him, you have to paint, and he gave him papers and colors, and he started to paint. He was a very religious man, so he painted only stories from the Bible. Very beautiful, very colorful. Also, as a storyteller, you see, it's all painted in what we call registers, and like a storyboard, actually. And this is a beautiful room of Gabriel Cohen. See, all this room is of Gabriel Cohen, who is an artist from Jerusalem, who started to paint when he was around 40, and he was discovered by a gallerist called Ruth Direktor, a gallerist from Jerusalem. You can see her portrait there. And she actually discovered him when he presented his pieces on the pavement in Jerusalem. She saw it, she immediately fell in love with his pieces. She said, you're a genius, and
and she exhibited his pieces. So all what you see here are paintings of Gabriel Cohen, a naive folk artist from Israel. And there are many others, but you have to come to Haifa and see it all. So I'm looking forward to see you. Thank you very much.